replace our tongue swaller. An anti-venom for snake bites in neighboring India is available, but snake species there have evolved differently from the ones here. So their anti-venom is not a perfect match for Sri Lankan venoms. It can work, but only in enormous doses, and it can have side effects.
Try the other side.
Researchers at Animal Venom Research International want to create the first anti-venom specifically designed for Sri Lankan snake bites. This can be more valuable than gold, so obviously we want to make sure that every single drop is saved. The venom yield on that was ridiculous. I mean, that's a huge, huge amount of venom. That's in there, on ice. So the last thing I want to do is make sure this guy gets back up into his tree. He donates a lot of samples. Any snake venoms I can collect will go to research the Sri Lankan anti-venom.
Go back up into your tree and relax.
And the more species I can sample, the more snake venoms that serum could treat. That's an absolutely beautiful specimen. Elephant that I'm looking for has been spotted on the other side of the village. This is a big male bull elephant, so it's huge, and it's also very territorial, so the likelihood of it attacking a human is pretty high. What we can do is track it down, get it sedated, get samples we need. We're specifically interested in looking at testosterone levels in these rogue elephants, and move out of the area. In the last 10 years, 500 people have been killed by raging elephants. The war has driven the bull we're looking for out of his territory and into this village. We know he's been shot several times, so we need to move him for his own safety.
This is the first time I've actually worked with Asian elephants, as you can tell. This is a village. This is where the big problem comes in with the conflict animals. There's a power line running through here, and there's actually houses getting through here.
When male elephants hit puberty, they test